Outside a shopping mall in Beijing, officials delivering a blunt message. Hammers smashing counterfeit merchandise, luggage bearing big brand names like Samsonite and Delsey. We oppose products that violate property rights to be sold in our Silk Market stores, says the CEO of the Chinese retailer. We think these products should not be sold anywhere else. But it's China's banks that are in many cases being used by counterfeiters to keep the money from the sale of their phony goods. An AP investigation revealing some of China's largest state-owned banks serve as safe havens for counterfeiters and their cash, being used to process credit card payments and move the money around the globe. This year, the counterfeiting industry is expected to top $1.8 trillion.
It's a global problem. It's a significant problem.
Bob Barkhazy is the president of the International Anti-Counterfeiting Coalition, which represents a number of businesses affected by counterfeiting. Many items are sold on legitimate-looking websites like this one, offering high-end jewelry at rock-bottom prices. They're shipped one at a time in small packages to customers in the U.S. and elsewhere, making it hard for customs officials to spot.
This is the best one.
Corporations are often unable to track down the counterfeiters and seize assets as Chinese banks cite Chinese privacy laws. In one case, a Chinese bank froze a counterfeiter's money to pay the legal fees it incurred to fight Chinese attempts by U.S. banks to obtain information about the accounts.
So those banks, in turn, although they know that these are high-risk merchants because they make a higher profit by taking on those merchants, they take that risk to facilitate those e-commerce transactions.
In a statement, the Bank of China said that U.S. lawsuits had put it in a, quote, impossible position, caught between U.S. court orders that compel the bank to freeze, turn over, or disclose information, and Chinese law, which requires the bank not to freeze or turn over accounts in China. Luxury brands Tiffany and Gucci now fighting the Bank of China and others to hand over counterfeiters' data and cash. Dozens of counterfeit items sit on display at the National Museum of Crime and Punishment in Washington, D.C., and it's not just luxury items that are counterfeited. Beverages, toys, even medicines and electronics shipped to retailers who may have thought they were purchasing the real thing.
Several years ago, a 7-year-old boy in Thailand was found dead, electrocuted by a counterfeit game charger. I don't think the parents bought the game charger knowing it was counterfeit.
According to the UK Trading Standards Institute, that boy is Connor O'Keefe, a British citizen. He was killed after parents purchased the charger while on vacation, not knowing the device was counterfeit. Despite the problems accessing counterfeiters' finances, Barkhazy's organization says he has had some success. It helped shut down nearly 5,000 accounts linked to more than 200,000 websites selling counterfeit goods. Robert Bumstead, Associated Press.